La ilaha illallah, what a scene it's going to be for those people, for everybody actually.
For the jinns, for the ins, for the humankind, for the mankind, for the first, for the last. For every single living creature Allah has created, right from the beasts of the jungle, right down to the smallest creatures Allah has created. Every single thing will be brought back to life again. Everything. The giants of Ad and Thamud will be towering on this day of judgment. From their arms and their limbs that were torn apart through the tornado, they will be brought on the day of judgment. Qawm Lut, those women who wanted to seek men and so on, and the whole earth was crushed upon them around the Dead Sea, Allah will bring them back to life again from nothing. Abu Lahab will be there on the day of judgment. Abu Jahl will be there, Fir'aun will be there, Qarun will be there, Haman will be there. Allah will bring about his every worst enemy, every enemy that was of great stance in this world, great height of this world, and the one that was of the lowest, and every friend, everyone that was close to Allah, Allah will bring them on the day of judgment as well. And this will be the final show. This will be when every man will be challenged, every woman will be challenged to try and speak out. Allah has called this day Yawm al-Fasl, the day when everything will be judged. Yawm al-Hashr, the day when everyone will be gathered. Yawm al-Jam', the day when everyone not only gathered, Yawm al-Ba'th, the day everyone will be resurrected. This will be a day, Yawm la yantiqoon, no one speaking. يوم لا ينطقون وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسا. When all the sounds, all voices, all shouts, all cries will become humble for the Rahman, for the one most merciful. What will be on the tongues of these people? يا سلام يا سلام يا سلام. The prophets will be saying, these are the tongue from the of the prophets on that day. Ya salam, ya salam, ya salam, sallim, sallim. A one who is of peace, establish peace on this day. Every prophet from Nuh alayhi salam, from Adam alayhi salam, all the way to Isa alayhi salam will be saying this. Ya salam, ya salam. These from the tongues of the prophets, let alone the tongues of those of us who have got no status in front of our Lord. And subhanallah, what a day it will be when Allah will bring about the destruction of what we see. Allah had said, قُلْ مَتَاعُ الدُّنْيَا قَلِيلٌ وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِّمَنِ اتَّقَى. Say, O Prophet, tell them, this world that you have, it's only مَتَاعُ الدُّنْيَا قَلِيلٌ, it's only a temporary means that you have. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِّمَنِ اتَّقَى. The next world is much better for the one who has fear of his Lord. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبَقَى. The next world is better and a much everlasting place for you. مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدُ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقٌ. What you have with you right now will be perished. What you have will be gone. And what you've left with Allah will be lasting. يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا. The day when every single soul will find in front of it the actions that it did, the good actions it will find it next to it. وَمَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ سُوءٍ. And the evil actions that it had committed in this world will be in front of it as well. تَوَدُّ لَوْ أَنَّ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَهُ أَمَدًا بَعِيدًا. It will wish, if only, the distance between the east and the west, the distance between that much, would be the distance between himself and his evil deeds on that day. The sins that we are carrying, my brothers, The sins that we've got, my sisters, these are sins we better get rid of in this world.
من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها. Whoever will bring me one good deed on this day,
I will give them 10 times more than that on the day of judgment. Whoever will bring me one single bad deed, من جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها. You bring me a bad deed, you will not see anything in return, except that you will see evil in return of evil. هل جزاء السيئة إلا سيئة مثلها. You bring me evil this day, you will see evil in return of this day, in return of your bad deeds. هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان. You have done good for me in this world, you will see good and excellence for you in the next world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show my brothers who has might, who has power. Allah has given us power, He has given us wealth, He has given us whatever we want to do. And He has said, اعملوا ما شئتم إنه بما تعملون بصير. O man, you do what you want in this world, for your Lord is watching you. فمن شاء فليؤمن وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ.
You want to believe in this message, then believe in this message. You want to disbelieve in this message, then disbelieve in this message. Because in the next life, إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا جَهَنَّمَ إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ نَارٌ أَحَاطَ بِهِمْ سُرَادِقُهَا. In the next life, I have created such rooms and such places that all four walls are
made of fire, and you will be right in between there. If you don't believe in this message, you will be right in between four walls of fire. This is for the next life. And those who believe in this message, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِنُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ.
Those who have believed in this message and they have done good deeds, Allah says what?
لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارِ. They will have gardens that are prepared for them in the next world. Underneath them there are rivers that are flowing. And what will they wear? يَلْبَسُونَ مِنْ سُنْدُسٍ خُضُرٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ مُتَّكِئِينَ. Allah has said He will give them such garments that will be made of silk. They will be wearing those proudly on the day when Allah will favor these servants in Jannah. Subhanallah. And we're waiting, my brothers and sisters, we're waiting for what? We're waiting for our death. If you're not waiting for your death, then you are in ghafla. If you're not thinking about your death, you're in ghafla, you're in an absent-minded state. For death is something which is a truth and it will come. And it will come without telling you that it's going to come. When it comes, Allah has said what? And many of us are trying to lead lives running away from death, taking extra care with our bodies. Take this, my brother. Come on, bruv, take this. Get some strength inside you. Get some strength inside you. Build your body up, bruv. Play football every week. Nothing's going to happen to you, bruv. You stay nice and fit. And you see these pictures and images and videos of football players that are completely, completely fit. And they meet angel of death right on the football ground. Yes or no, brothers?
Yes.
They meet him right on the football ground. Completely healthy, completely fit. Nothing is wrong with them. And they meet death where? On the football field. There are, my brothers, my death and your death has been written. What moment we're going to die, what place we're going to die. And you know what? However much you avoid death, we will go down the pathway where our death is waiting for us. If you've got five different choices or places to go, you will go to that. You will choose out of the five. In fact, if you had 50 choices to avoid death and you pick one out of 50, you will pick the one that death is written for you. You will pick that. Allah says, وَلَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيَّدَةٍ. Even if you lock yourselves up in high towers, you have no doors to get inside, you have no windows to get inside, you are completely inside, what will happen? Allah says, death will come to you. Death sees no walls. Death sees no barriers in front of it. And when it comes, Allah says, قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. Remind them, O Prophet, and tell them from the death that they are trying to run away from, that death will come and meet you, and that death will return you to your Lord. The angel of death will take you to your Lord, to the one who knows the seen, the one who knows the unseen. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And your Lord will tell you about all the deeds that you did. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوهُ. Men forget what deeds they did on this earth. Allah says, وَكُلُّكُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. Each one of you will come to me single, one by one. أَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَدَّا. I have counted each and every one of you from the beginning until the end. How many insan and how many human beings have been created? I have the number. Allah says, I've got the number. Exact number of human beings that need to be there on the Day of Judgment. And Allah does not need to count. And every person will come alone. Farda. And when they come, what? أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوهُ. You have forgotten the deeds that you have done, but I haven't forgotten what you've done. I've counted every single deed. Every deed that you've done. Right to the smallest deed. What will happen when you put your head up and you come on the Day of Judgment and you see it? Allah has said, Subhanallah.
يَوْمَئِذٍ يَسْطُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا. In Surah Zilzal, the 99th Surah of the Quran.
The day when people will be brought together on their Day of Judgment, scattered in different groups.
لِيُرَوْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. So that he may show them their deeds.
فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ. Whoever has done a single atom's weight of a deed, whoever has thought of sin in his heart but he never did the sin, whoever thought of a good deed in his heart but he never did that good deed, that person will see that good deed on the Day of Judgment. Whether it was a blink of an eye, whether it was moving their eyes in such a way behind someone's back that they would disapprove of. You know, somebody behind their back, you go, yeah. Allah has mentioned that in the Holy Quran. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ.
Woe to those who use the tongue in the wrong way, who use the eyes in the wrong way. The slightest deed you do will be there on the Day of Judgment.
الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ. He was gathering wealth in the earth, he was counting it. يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ. He thought his wealth will be something that will make him last for good.
يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ.
He thought what? His wealth will be something that will make him last forever. When is death going to come? It'll come one day, doesn't matter, it'll come. Those people who don't think of death, they celebrate, you know, they celebrate many birthdays.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ahmed. Happy birthday to you.
You know what they should really sing? Should they really sing?
Happy birthday to you. One more year closer to death. Happy birthday to you. Deep down there in the grave.
You know, every birthday that comes, what's happening? Every birthday that comes, what's happening is that you're one more year closer to your death. Time has gone by. It's a time to reflect. It's a time to reflect. It's 1 year less from your own deeds. If you take an hourglass and you got sand in there and you turn the hourglass upside down, the sand that falls at the bottom, is it something, and you've got time running out, is it something that you should be happy about or something that you should be sad about? And you know what? Subhanallah,
the older we get, the younger we get in our minds. I've met 50-year-olds who tell me they're still young. I've heard about deaths of 60-year-olds and people talking about them and saying, oh, he died quite young. 58-year-old died, and some people were saying, oh, died quite young. La ilaha illallah, died young. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, A'maru ummati bayna 60 wa 70 sana. In a hadith of Bukhari said, the average lifespan of my ummah will be between 60 to 70 years. If you live up to 60 to 70 years of a life, you've had a very good life. In fact, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah, when he got to the age of 40, he increased his ibadah to the extent like no other. Nothing like before. He was doing ibadah before anyway as it was. And when he got to 40, he was staying awake most of his nights, reading as much Quran as he could, doing as much ibadah as he could. And somebody said to him, Imam, what is it? Why are you doing this? Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he said, Allah has said in the Holy Quran, حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ وَبَلَغَ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. When man comes to the best of his life, the most peak of his life, the strongest part of his life, and he reaches the age of 40. My brothers, anyone reaching 40, you're reaching a peak. Anyone over 40, you're going downhill now. Anyone who's got a good body after 40, just do Alhamdulillah every single day. Every single day, just carry on saying, for every limb in your body, just carry on saying Alhamdulillah. The longer you have a good body after 40, the better you are. Because when that moment comes, my brothers, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Man mata faqad qamat qiyamatu. Whoever has died, their day of judgment has started. Last month we covered about the grave. And we're all going to be in our graves. Some of us will be in the company of our wudu, company of our salah, company of our sadaqah, company of our fasting. And others, na'udhu billah, may Allah protect us. May Allah protect us. Some will be in the company of snakes, of scorpions, and other things on fire in the grave. But for every single individual, there will be a point when the adab will stop, whenever Allah will. Because in the Holy Quran, those who have even denied the verses of Allah, denied the signs of Allah, denied the Quran, they will get up and they will say what? Ya waylana man ba'athana min marqadina. Woe to us who has woken us up from the places that we are residing in, we were sleeping in. هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. This is what the Most Merciful One has promised. This is what the messengers have attested to. On the Day of Judgment, some people will get up, those who have denied this message, and they will say, who from the resting places? Which means what? Mufassirun have commented there, that the Adhabul Qabr, or the punishment of the grave, will continue till whenever Allah wants. No one knows how long that will be. For different people, it will be different time lengths. In fact, Allah, the Adhabul Qabr, the punishment of the grave, starts straight away. For Fir'aun, if you want to find a dalil or an evidence from the Quran about Adhabul Qabr, then it is in the Holy Quran in Surah Mu'min, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about Fir'aun and his men. When they were drowned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said straight away that they will be entered into a fire. This is in Surah number 40, Surah Mu'min, verse number 46. An-naru yu'raduna 'alayha ghudwan wa 'ashiyya. Morning and evening there is fire that is going around, fire that is presented to them. Wa yawma taqumu as-sa'a adkhilu 'ala fir'auna ashadd al-'adhab. And when the hour will come, the final day, Allah will say, now put Fir'aun and his men into the worst of punishment. So what does that mean? The Mufassirun have clearly said that this is perhaps one of the strongest evidence in the Quran for the punishment of the grave. Because on the Day of Judgment, Allah will say, put him in more punishment. And before that, Allah says, there is fire that is going around night and day. Night and day fire is going around. What does that mean? That while they are still residing in their graves, or in the case of Fir'aun, while he's being taken from museum to museum. Have you seen the picture of Fir'aun? Have you seen him? He's totally intact. And while you see him intact, his ruh and his soul is being punished with the fire. And we can't comprehend that. We can't see that. He's being punished at this moment right now. Wallahu a'lam. Allah knows best. But he's going to be punished until the Day of Judgment. Allah will say, then put him into the fire. Worst of the punishment on the Day of Judgment. So when that time will come, my brothers, we will all be in our graves, because you will not find Day of Judgment on this earth here while you're walking on it. Why? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, according to a hadith of Bukhari, لا تقوم الساعة حتى لا يقال في الأرض الله الله. The Day of Judgment will not come. Day of Judgment will not occur until there's no one on the earth who is saying Allah Allah. When every Muslim has been wiped out from the earth. And Allah will wipe these Muslims out Himself. So to those enemies of Islam who are trying to wipe every single Muslim out, you will never succeed. Because Allah is the one that He will wipe all the believers out in the end. He will send a wind. And this wind will come, and wherever it finds believers, it will make them just die there. And there will be no one after that. No believer will remain on the earth. And the worst of people will be alive on the earth. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Qiyamah will come ala ashrarin nas. The worst of people, Qiyamah, or the Day of Judgment, will occur on them. So you know this big thing about 2012 being the end of the world. Have you heard of that? Yeah? 2012 being the end of the world. Yeah? Walk around with a big smile on your face. Walk around with a big smile on your face. And the next person you meet with this theory about 2012 being, tell him that, you know what, we have been given by Allah through our Prophet, the future has been given to us. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. You know, we are not people who are lost. Alhamdulillah. We're not people who are craving for this world, because this world is what for us? It's only like Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu said, Ad-dunya mazra'ul akhirah. Ad-dunya mazra'ul akhirah. This world is only cultivating land for the next world. This world is a means for the next world. We don't die for this world. We don't die for these buildings out there. And the oil and the different gifts, palaces and islands and boats and ships that they buy and whatever they want to buy. And all the women of this world, or whatever it is nothing to us. Nothing. Because the mu'min and the believer looks towards what they're getting in the next world. Because this world, everything inside is gone. Your wife one day, my brother, my sister, will be my sister for your husband. I'm saying your wife and your husband, they will be what? They will be dead people in the grave. Gone. Your brothers, your sisters. 3 generations from today. And you will be a forgotten man on this earth. Forgotten woman on this earth. Tell me how many of you visit your great-great-grandparents. Tell me. Nobody even knows who your great-great-grandparents are, where they're buried. No one even knows. No hands were shown here. 3 generations time. 100 years time from now. Your grave will not even be visited. You'll be a forgotten person. Your land, forget it. Some other guy is basically, he doesn't even know who owned it 4 generations before. And he's going to be living in your property, my property, and eating from this earth, from the things that I've earned today and left behind me. He's going to eat. This world has no significance. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was on Mi'raj, and he saw a woman, an old woman, long hair, old, ugly woman. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam inquired with Jibreel. He said, "Who is this?" Jibreel sallam said, "This is the dunya. This is the world. This is the world. And it is as old as it looks," meaning that it's coming to its end. It's coming to its end. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, "Bu'ithu was-sa'a kahatayn." According to Sahih Hadith in Bukhari, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his 2 fingers up. And he said, "I have been sent as close to the Day of Judgment like these 2 fingers of mine. The closeness of these 2 fingers of mine." My brothers and my sisters, Qiyamah is coming, is going to come. But we don't know Allahu Alam when it's going to come, but it's going to come. But it's not going to be 2012, I'll just tell you that now, okay? Okay, you know there was that other theory about Nostradamus who said that 1999, July the 7th, the world's going to end. And I had a big smile on my face. And the next khutbah, Jummah khutbah, I told everybody, I said, look at this falsehood. We're alive, and I knew we was going to be alive, because you're saying Allah, Allah on the earth, Qiyamah will not come upon you. It will not come. So we're going to be in our graves at that time. But what will happen to the people who are on this earth? La ilaha illallah. What Allah will do will be something that no eye has ever seen, such catastrophe. And Israfil alayhi salam is waiting at this moment, wide awake with the horn in his mouth, ready for Allah's permission to be given to him. And our Prophet sallallahu has told us, according to a sahih hadith, he has said, Kaifa, he said, how do I get rest? How will I get rest when Israfil is ready, waiting for the command of his Lord to blow this horn? In fact, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told in the Quran to say, وَمَا أَدْرِي Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَا أَدْرِي مَا يُفْعَلُ بِي وَلَا بِكُمْ Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told to say in the Quran, which is in 46 surah, verse number 9, I do not know what exactly is going to happen to me in its totality and what is going to happen to you. Yes, he has given us information about the next life, about the signs of the last hour, about the day of judgment. Everything he said is absolutely true. But to the exact facts and details, only Allah has that knowledge. And even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not have the knowledge of when the hour is going to come. So let's not bother about when the day of judgment is going to come. But we know that there are going to be signs for the day of judgment. Most of those minor signs, in fact, all the minor signs have appeared. And they are only getting worse and worse. For when the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that alcohol and things will be prevalent more on the earth, we see it's going to get worse and worse. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said zina, and something will be very common on the earth, we can see it today. When he said bloodshed is going to be on a high and an increase, we can see it in the earth, and it's just going to get worse and worse. But the 10 major signs of the last day, they are awaiting. And before the 10 major signs of the last day is going to be Imam Mahdi. He's going to be the last of the minor signs, first of the major signs. And then there's going to be 10 following him of Dajjal, and of Ya'juj Ma'juj, of Isa alayhi salam, of the fire that will come, of the earthquakes. And this talk is not about that. So I'm not going to go into that at all. Maybe perhaps in the future or something, we might cover that, or some other speaker can cover that. But don't get into these theories, okay, that Mahdi is born. Imam Mahdi is born. Ulama are writing letters to one another. They know that he's born. Wow. Where are these secret letters? In the Pentagon? These theories have been here decade after decade, you hear them. And people just spread them around. And then there's this guy, you know, there's these conspiracies, the Illuminati, and the secrets, the secret Freemasons. And bro, they're gonna get you. They got you. They got your name, they got your house number, they got you. My brother, la ilaha illallah, come get a life. How are you supposed to get on this earth and walk around with all these theories, like the satellites watching me, the cameras watching me, they take my credit card out, wipe it, oh my God, they know what I bought. I mean, how are you supposed to live your life? How are you supposed to live your life? And let me remind you, Allah is the one who is Sami'un Basir. Allah is Sami'un Basir. Yes or no? Allah hears everything, Allah sees everything. These people, subhanallah al-azim, I'm not saying this man was a good man. I'm not here to endorse anything, okay? I'm not saying he was a good man. But it took him took them 10 years to find bin Laden, didn't it? How long did it take? 10. How long did it take? 10. 10 years with all the satellites, with all the devices, with all those systems you say, Illuminati and Freemason and all of that. It took them how long? 10 years to find them. And all those 10 years, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew exactly where he was. Yes or no?
Yes.
And he knew where all the others were, and who was chasing him, and where they're chasing him, and where he was, and all his bad deeds. Bin Laden's bad deeds and Bin Laden's good deeds, Allah knows all of them. I'm not here to say, to praise him, okay? My MI6 friend, okay, please. I must share a joke with you though. I might look like him, but I'm not him. I was just, you know, 10 years ago, when they first showed him, I was at a traffic light. Okay, I was parked up, just waiting for the red to go to green. And there's some young white youths in the car, and they're all laughing. So I'm looking at them, thinking, what they're laughing for? It's summer day, windows are down. So one of them goes to me, "Are you Bin Laden? Are you Bin Laden?" And I said, "No, I'm his brother." And they start looking at me, and I said, "Listen, hey guys, you're gonna get $25 million. This is how." And the lights turn green, and I start zooming off. I said, "Catch me." And then, subhanallah, soon as his death is announced, just 2 days after his death, I'm going down Wood Green. I'm at a again at a traffic light waiting, and there's two black brothers who are at a bus stop with their dreadlocks and so on, and they look at me, and one of them goes to me. My window's again down. He looks at me and says, "Eddie Bass, yeah, look alike, you know." And I looked back at him and I said, "Yeah, they think me dead, innit?" And they start laughing. So I might look like him, but I'm not him, okay? So anyway, whatever is the case, Allah is the one who watches us. Allah is the one who sees us. And we have to keep that in mind, not the satellites and not everything else. I don't care what else is happening outside there. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is a beautiful hadith. He said, if one of you is planting a seed and the day of judgment comes upon him, then continue to plant your seed. Subhanallah. Continue. Why? What does that mean? That means you should not be bothered about the greatest things or catastrophe. Don't be bothered about what might happen, what might happen. Unless, of course, it is actually the great catastrophe. Meaning that don't go into this series so much that your life becomes something miserable. There are some brothers I know, Muslim brothers, who are so paranoid. Paranoid about this, paranoid about that, this is going to happen. We should not lead a life like this. We should basically feel that Allah is the one watching us and watching those who are watching us. وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. And they plot and Allah makes plans. And Allah is the best of those who makes plans. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the best of those who makes plans. So my brother who is watching this, I know there's going to be a lot of non-Muslims watching this. To my non-Muslim brothers and sisters, you're my brothers and sisters as well. Why? Because Rasulullah has two ummas. He has two communities. One community are those people who've accepted the Shahada, and the others are those who haven't accepted the Shahada, but you are still brothers. And I say this according to a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, where Prophet ﷺ said, "La yu'minu ahadukum hatta yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsi." This hadith, according to Imam Nawawi, rahimahullah, he says that the scholars are absolutely unanimous. They have all agreed that this hadith, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "None of you will truly believe until you love for your brother what you love for yourself," Imam Nawawi says all scholars have agreed that this brother mentioned in his hadith is not your Muslim brother; he is your brother in humanity. He's your brother who has it, whether he's got iman or no iman, he's your brother. To my non-Muslim brothers and sisters, I'm saying. What I'm going to say in this lecture, you better listen to it very carefully, because this is going to happen to me and to you. And when that striking hour comes, and when death has come, and when my day of judgment is about to start, everything that I'm going to say from the Quran is going to be an absolute truth. And the way I see you, wallahi, I will say to you, there's absolutely no disbelief in my heart about this day of judgment. It's as true as I'm seeing you right now. And we should basically feel the same as well. There's some brothers who say to me, you know, say, "Imam, what about if you wake up on the day of judgment and basically some other religion is the true religion?" Yes, I've been asked this a few times. If you've got that kind of doubt, you seriously need to go and see an imam and to put your arguments in front of, you know, the imam, and to debate and to take that doubt away. You cannot be a believer and believe that you will die and wake up or be frightened in the graveyard just in case they come to you and they say to you, "Who's your Lord?" And you have to say, you know, "The aliens on the third sky." "Who's your Lord?" "I don't have one, I better become an atheist." You cannot believe that you're going to be there in the grave on the day of judgment. You're going to be asked a question and you will try and see who made it, who was the real one. You are the real ones. You have been given iman, I've been given iman. You know how lucky we are? La ilaha illallah, you know how lucky we are? Out of all the different people of this whole of the world, you know, my Shaykh made a dua once. And he said in his dua, Oh Allah, did we ever say to you, ever, that create us, make us live, We didn't. But you gave us the gift of hayat. You gave us the gift of life. And then he says, O Allah, amra kono din tumare khoiseni maula. Tumi amrare sorboshreshtho. O Allah, did we ever tell you any time to make us the most noble of your creation? You made us human beings. O Allah, this is your gift. And then he says, O Allah, tumare kono din khoiseni maula. Tumi amrare mumin banaitai. Did we ever say, O Allah, that to create us from human beings, yes, but to make us and to be born Muslims, Allahu Akbar. And then he says, O Allah, tumara kunu din khusini maula, tumi amdare ummat Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ummat banaitai. O Allah, did we ever tell you to make us be born as a believer and to be part of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know how much of a gift that is to us, brothers. We will be the most proudful people on the Day of Judgment. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be the most proud Nabi and Prophet on the Day of Judgment. He said, "Ana ukathiru bikumul umam yawm al-qiyamah." He said, "I will show my lawful pride on the Day of Judgment. My lawful pride, I will be the most proud Prophet on the Day of Judgment. Because I will have the greatest gathering. Greatest gathering. The greatest ummah of the world is going to be this ummah. And we are part of that. And our Prophet is the one that will go ahead and who will intercede when no other Prophet is able to go ahead and intercede." Such a wonderful gift we have been given. And brothers and sisters, we have this iman. This iman is what? This iman is something that you have to secure until your death. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah haqqa tuqatih. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ تَمُونَ. O you who believe, fear Allah the way He ought to be feared, and do not come to a state of death when you don't have Islam inside you. Have Islam when you die. Have Islam. Because when we wake up, brothers and sisters, we will find the truth that it has been said in the Quran, in the Sunnah. And to my non-Muslim brothers and sisters, I'm saying, please listen carefully, because these are occurrences that are going to take place. So what's going to happen? After the 10 major signs, when the worst of people are on this earth, when all of us are in our graves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order one day, He will order Israfil to blow. And when He blows, His blowing is going to be first very sweet, a very melodious tune that will come out of that horn, that every person on the earth alive will stop to listen to that call. Whatever that sound is, it's going to come as a sweet little sound. And people will look around, people in the marketplace will stop buying and selling. Children will come out of the houses, women will come out as well. Children will actually stop playing, women will come out of the houses. And when that sound basically starts blowing, it will slowly get louder and louder. And when it gets louder and louder, my brothers, everything that we see, the sound will reach it, and it will get so strong that people will start then holding their ears. It's going to be deafening. They won't be able to bear it. It will be so loud. Can you imagine that the sound itself creates these things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that will happen on the Day of Judgment? Basically, this is the beginning of the Day of Judgment, and these things will happen. Allah says in Surah number 27, verse number 87, وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَفَزِعَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. The day when the horn will be blown, every single creature, every living thing will be absolutely terrified, except for those whom Allah want not to be terrified. وَكُلٌّ أَتَوْهُ دَاخِرِينَ. And everyone will come to Allah humbled in front of His presence. Everything will start shaking. Everything will be terrified to the extent that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained this in more than one place of the Holy Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, what will happen with this? وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا. They ask you about the mountains, what will happen to the mountains? Say that my Lord will make it turn to dust. The mountains, first what will happen is the mountain will start blowing from its place. Is there anything on this earth that can move a mountain, my brothers? Nothing. Allah said that sound will move the mountains. In the same, around the same verse, Allah said, وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ. If you were there when the day of judgment is going to occur, you are seeing right now the mountains are in their positions, in their places. When the horn will be blown, you will see the mountains sailing across the sky. فَقُلْ رَبِّي يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفَى. My Lord is someone who is going to turn all these mountains into dust. Into dust Allah will turn them. This is in Surah Taha, which is the 20th Surah of the Quran. It's in verse number 105. فَيَذَرُهَا قَعَنْ صَفَّفًا لَا تَرَى فِيهَا عِبَجًا وَلَا أَمْتَى. Allah says on that day you will not see a single hill, you will not see a single ditch. Allah will make everything plain. And what is it with the mountains? Allah says the sound will be so great. Allah says, وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِهْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ. The whole mountain will turn into soft wool first, and then after that it will turn into dust and become completely flat. That's the mountains. Can you imagine what will happen to the human beings that are around at that time? Allah has said in the Holy Quran, in Surah Takwir, which is the 81st Surah, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ. Because of that sound, when the sun will lose its balance and will start to fall down, will start to twirl and fall down from its place in the orbit, in the space. وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ كَدَرَتْ. Following that, the stars will lose their light. Stars will lose their light and they will fall. وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ. When the mountains will be flying across the air. وَإِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ. By this time, the 10-month she-camel, pregnant she-camel, will be abandoned. وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشِرَتْ. When you will find the different animals that will be running into the cities and they will be gathered. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ. Because of the sound, when the oceans will be lit fire, the oceans will be set on fire. وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ. When different souls will be brought together. How will the oceans go into fire, my brothers? When there is an earthquake underneath the ocean, there's fires that start, and we have witnessed this on this earth. And that's what will happen to the oceans on that day of judgment, the beginning of the day of judgment. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ. When that young infant girl will be asked, بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. For which sin was she slain, and why did the Arabs kill her? Just because she was a girl, she was killed, buried alive in the ground, and she will be asked, Allah will say, why was you slain? وَإِذَا الصُّحُفُ نُشِرَتْ. When people's accounts will be brought out, and they will be flying about. وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ كُشِطَتْ. When the whole sky will split. وَإِذَا الْجَحِيمُ سُعِرَتْ. When Jahannam will be given a final blaze, it will be blazing hot and fierce on the day of judgment. وَإِذَا الْجَنَّةُ أُزْلِفَتْ. When Jannah and paradise will be brought near. For the muttaqeen, for those people who have taqwa, Jannah will be very close to them. I know it's going to be far from everyone, but Allah will make it seem very close to them. They will be able to get there very easily. عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا أَحْضَرَتْ. Every single soul will know what it has brought for that day. My brothers, we are sending things for that day. And these amal we're doing, they are parcels for the next day. إِذَا السَّمَاءٌ فَطَرَتْ. When the sky will split. This is in Surah Infitar, the 82nd Surah. وَإِذَا الْكَوَاكِبُ انْتَثَرَتْ. When the different stars will start to separate from one another. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ فُجِّرَتْ. When you will find that the seas are split. وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْثِرَتْ. When all the graves will be turned over. عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخَّرَتْ. That day, every single soul will say, this is what I sent forward, this is what I have today, and this Allah I should have done. I should have done that. I should have done that. There's going to be both happiness and regret on that day. Why? Because the things that we've sent will make us really happy. The amal that we did will make us happy. The tahajjud that we did, subhanallah, those of us who wake up in the middle of the night, Allah says what? فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنْ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Those who kept their sides away from their beds in the night time just to stand in front of me. The eye does not know the many delicious things that I have kept for them. The eye does not know what I've kept. I've kept it hidden from that. جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. This is going to be a reward for you for the actions that you have done for me. This is in Surah Alif Lam Mim As-Sajdah. What does Allah say? أَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَلَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْمَأْوَى نُزُلًا بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. You have done, you have believed in me, you did these good actions for me, you not only prayed your five salahs, but you also did tahajjud for me. For you on this day there is going to be Jannatul Ma'wa, your abode is Jannah, your abode is Jannah, paradise is your abode, subhanallah. فَلَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ مَأْوَى نُزُلًا بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. The word نُزُلًا is a beautiful word, my brothers. What is it? نُزُلًا بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. You are no other guest of any other host except for the Rahman. You are my guest and I am your host. نُزُلًا means that. You are going to come down. I am going to send my servants in paradise to serve you in Jannah. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فَسَقُوا فَمَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارُ. And those who sinned on this earth, this is Muslims and non-Muslims. Don't just think these are just for non-Muslims. A very great dishonor to ourselves is that when we read the ayats of Jahannam in the Quran, we continuously think of the kafirs and not about the Muslims. That's wrong. The word kafaru means what? Kafaru has two meanings. One word, one meaning of kafaru or kuffar and so on means those who disbelieve in this message. And the other word, the same word also has the meaning of those who hide the ni'mah and the gift of Allah. Those who are ungrateful to Allah, that's what it means. That's why Allah said in the Quran, what did he say? فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا. You hear the Imam saying that almost every khutbah. فَذْكُرُونِي, Allah says in Surah Baqarah, in the second surah of the Holy Quran, in around the 154th verse. فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. O believers, remember me and I will remember you. وَشْكُرُوا لِي, and show thanks to me. وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ, and don't be ungrateful to me. Kufr can also be used for the believer. One great dishonor and disservice we've done to ourselves is when we read the Quran and we read Jannah, Allahu Akbar, those hurains of mine, huh? What does Allah say about them? Oh, that's how their eyes look. Oh, yes, yes, very, very nice. And the trees, oh, and the long, long, long different shadows that I will have and the palaces, subhanallah. And my enemies are in hellfire. They are rotting like anything, stinking, screaming. Is that the way to approach the Quran, Layla? That's not the way to approach the Quran. The way to approach the Quran is every single person needs to use this Quran as a mirror. This is my soul's mirror. This is your mirror, this Quran. Because why? How is the Quran a mirror? If I find a bad deed in my life, and it's in this Quran, I am going to be that person. That's my mirror. That's me on the Day of Judgment. If I find a good deed in my life, and I find the same good deed in this Quran, that's me in the next life. That's my mirror. And the Quran and the Sunnah is not supposed to be used to mirror Jahannam with one's enemies and mirror Jannah with oneself. That's not the way. Be absolutely honest with yourself. Absolutely honest. Because the Quran, for those people who have, subhanAllah, for those people who have received the blessings of Allah, there are certain qualities they have and they must strive for them. And do we honestly think, we should never think, look, then we need to get a balance, please. We need to do every single good deed we can, and we need to never leave a single bad, we need to do every single good deed we can. We should not leave any good deed, even the minute of good deeds. We should not leave them around. And every single bad deed we stay away from, even the most littlest ones. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, according to Hadith of Bukhari, he said, "Uridat alayya a'malu ummati." My amal, the amal of my ummah, the actions of my ummah, of my community were presented to me. Mahasinuha, the good deeds and the bad deeds were all presented in front of me. Faraitu min mahasiniha, I saw from the most best of good deeds of my ummah. Imatatul adha anit tariq, I saw one man from my ummah, one woman from my ummah, who removed one harmful item from the pathway. That was from the best deeds Allah loved. How insignificant is that? The best deeds. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says what? And I also saw from the worst of deeds, someone's phlegm or someone's mucus from his nose inside the masjid. No one wants to clean it. This is one of the worst sins I have seen. Worst sins Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has seen. Subhanallah. Mucus from someone's nose inside the masjid. No one wants to remove. That's why, brothers, if you see in the wudu area someone has left something of a mess in the wudu area, just clean it. From the best of deeds, just clean it. And you will see on the Day of Judgment what Allah will give us. My brothers, this is the true approach. That on the Day of Judgment there will be certain people, subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what in the Hadith of Bukhari? رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا يَتَقَلَّبُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ, I saw a man in Jannah. Allah has shown me a man who basically moves from his sides. He moves from his sides. Resting in Jannah, he's lying down. You know, sometimes you're having a really nice lie down and you're like, oh, ooh, that felt really good. You know, when you have that really good feeling, yeah? He says, I saw a man doing that inside Jannah. Why did he get to Jannah? Fi shajaratin, this man saw a tree and it had a low branch. People had to duck down to go across the branch. And this man just cut the branch so that people don't have to duck down, and he entered into Jannah. Subhanallah. Entered into Jannah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the one person who stole something in his time, he said, this thing will stop him from getting into Jannah. Subhanallah. In fact, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قُمْتُ عَلَىٰ بَابِ الْجَنَّةِ, I stood at the door of Jannah. This must have been when Prophet ﷺ went to Mi'raj. قُمْتُ عَلَىٰ بَابِ الْجَنَّةِ, I stood at the door of Jannah. فَرَأَيْتُ أَكْثَرَهَا فُقَرَىٰ, I saw most of the people entering into Jannah. They are the poor people. Brothers, are you complaining you haven't got enough money? Say takbir! You haven't got much money? Doesn't matter. Perhaps on the Day of Judgment, I will be the first of the first to go into Jannah. وَرَأَيْتُ الْأَغْنِيَا مَحْبُوسِينَ, and I saw the rich people that were held back because of the accounts they had to give on the Day of Judgment. Every single penny that Allah had given them, where they had acquired it from, where they were giving it to, they had to give account to it. And he said, what did he say, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, the difference between these poor people going to Jannah and the rich people going to Jannah was a difference of 500 years. 500 years of accounts they were kept behind to give their accounts. What, you want to complain about the Day of Jannah? Don't, brother, subhanallah. The miseries of this world are nothing when we get to the other side. Both ways. If you see the miseries of the next world, there will be absolutely nothing of this world. And if you see the blessings of the next world, it will be absolutely nothing compared to what's happened in this world. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, according to Hadith of Muslim, two men will be brought on the Day of Jannah. One man that had all the happiest moments of this world, never ever did he suffer or complain from anything. The most happiest, the most delighted man, the most fortunate man will be brought on the Day of Judgment. He will be brought. And Allah will take him and he will just dip him in hellfire. Just a quick dip. And Allah will say to him, هَلْ رَأَيْتَ النِّعْمَةَ قَطْ, have you ever seen any delight or blessing in your life? He will say, never. And Allah will bring the most wretched, the most unfortunate, the most miserable, the person who's had the most misfortune in this life. And Allah will just bring him on the Day of Judgment. Allah will dip him in heaven, into Jannah, just once, take him out. And that person, Allah will ask him, have you ever seen, هَلْ رَأَيْتَ الْبُؤْسَ قَطْ, have you ever seen any misery in your life? And say, I've never seen misery in my life. Allah, there's never seen any misery in my life. You'll forget everything. You'll forget everything. And those of us brothers, subhanAllah, those of us who have sabr. Because all of us have had trials. Put your hand up in here if you're not in any problem in your life. Good. That means you're basically a human being. Right? You've got no... If you've got... My ustad, one of my teachers said, he said two types of people will not have any problems. They don't have experience any problems whatsoever. One person is what? One person is the one who is mad. Person is mad and is a human being, he's got no problems. No problems, he can do what he likes. And the other person is a dead man. If you're alive and if you're sane, you've got problems. And if you've got problems, Allah has given you the opportunity to do sabr. And Allah has said in the Holy Quran, what did he say? إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Surely Allah will be with those who are the patient ones. And what will Allah do with the ones who have sabr? Allah said in the Holy Quran, Allah has said, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Quran, Surah 16, verse number 96. Those people who have had patience in this world, and you bore patience for myself. There are many problems we've got, brothers. Many, many problems. Just have patience. Have patience. Allah says, I will give them their reward in such a way that will be the best in the way I can give. مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. For the action that they've done for me. My brothers, that day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the trumpet blow, mountains will fly, the whole cosmos and everything will start breaking down. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring about the destruction of everything on this earth. And anything that we see from the sun to the moon, Allah said in Surah Qiyamah, He said, فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرُ وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ. Allah will make the sun and the moon clash together. Because of that sound. It will bring a catastrophe like no other has seen. We will still be in our graves. What Allah will do, He will make everything be dead. Everything. Illa man sha Allah, except for whom Allah wills. And now Mufassirun have disagreed. Who are those Allah will? Some have said it is Jibreel. It is the angels that will hold Allah's arsh. They are the angels or Lawh Mahfuz. And it's going to be Israfil himself, Allah will keep alive. But the greatest of tafsir is that everything including Jibreel will perish. Everything, Jannah will perish, Jahannam, everything will be gone. Dead, as in nothing will be living. Even Israfil who's blowing in the horn, he is going to die. And Allah will make the angel of death die. And only then will the statement of Allah in Surah Ar-Rahman come to be. كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Everything on the earth, everything that is living, everything in the heavens, everything that was created, everything Allah says I made, everything will come to perish. Except for me, myself, I'll be the only one that will be alive. هُوَ الْأَوَّلُ وَالْآخِرُ وَالظَّاهِرُ وَالْبَاطِنُ. Allah is the first, Allah is the last, Allah is the one that we can, Allah is the one that is hidden, Allah is the one that is apparent. Allah is that one that will only be alive. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, between that moment and between the next blowing of the horn, Sayyiduna Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says, according to a sahih hadith in Bukhari, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا بَيْنَ النَّفْخَتَيْنِ أَرْبَعُونَ. Between the two blowings of the horn, there's going to be 40. Now nobody knows whether it's going to be 40 days, 40 years, 40 what, nobody knows. But there's going to be a period of 40. And between that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, قَدْ غَضِبَ غَضْبًا لَمْ يَغْضَبْ مِثْلَهُ قَطْ وَلَنْ يَغْضَبَ لَمْ يَغْضَبْ قَبْلَهُ مِثْلَهُ قَطْ وَلَنْ يَغْضَبَ بَعْدَهُ مِثْلَهُ أَبَدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never been angry ever before this like this, and Allah will never ever get angry ever like this ever again. And Allah basically will tell Israfil again, He'll make him come alive, and He will tell him to blow. And when he blows this time, between that and that, between the two, there's also a rain that comes down. And that rain will wash everything away and make it completely flat ground. And my grave, your grave is just underneath the earth at that time. Allah will shuffle the graves. Doesn't matter where you've died, my brother, you will wake up next to the one you loved. This is something to be concerned about. Who did you love most? There's going to be a rain that comes and washes everything. And then after that, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what has he said? He has said, everything dies. Except for one part of human being, one part that will not perish in the earth is ajbudham in this hadith of Bukhari. Ajbudham is the human coccyx, which is the lowest part of the spine. There's a rubbery part. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, from that Allah will make the human come back alive again. There's a professor, the doctor that I met in Surrey University some years back, and he did a whole PhD on this, on the ayah that talks about how Allah brings a tree that dies in the Sahara Desert or somewhere where it's absolutely dry, how Allah brings that tree back to life again. And he's done an exact analysis of that tree and the human being, and he's found that there is a tree, at the tree bottom of the tree there is a small rubbery part that stays in the ground. And when water reaches that comes back alive. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when the human's coccyx, the water will come there, it will basically come alive. And we will then come back to a life. We'll be completely dead. We'll come back with that horn blow. We'll come back alive. And now we see the day of judgment. I will talk about this, inshallah. After the Maghrib Salah, there's an announcement to be made right now. Jazakumullah khair. فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةِ When the great scream will take place with that horn blowing on the day of judgment, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ A brother from another brother will not want to be near him on the day of judgment, lest he ask him for some good reward that he has to give. They will run away from one another. وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِي A person will see his mother and he will run away from his mother. وَأَبِي From his father he will run away. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِي From his wife, from his children he will run away. لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِي Everyone will have a matter that will only make them concerned about themselves. وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَ On that day there will be faces that will be beaming with delight, like the morning sun that comes up. That's how their faces will be. Dahikatun mustabshira, laughing out loud, and they will be happy that day. Wawujuhun yawma'idhin alayha ghabara, and there will be faces on them, there will be dust. Tarhaquha qatara, there will only be disgrace and darkness on their faces. Ulaika humul kafaratul fajara, two types of people that will be: those people who denied this Quran, this message, and those people who were good, who were Muslims but were not good Muslims, they were sinners. On that day, what will happen? Yawma tubla sarair, when all your secrets will be in front of you. لا تخفى منكم خافية Not even a little thing that you held secret will be hidden from anyone. لا تخفى منكم Nothing will be hidden. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made that day when people come up and they will see the situation of the day. Allah has announced what this day is about. يوم الفتح This will be the day of victory for some people. This will be the day of opening for some people's account. Surah 33 verse 29. Yawmal khulud, this will be the permanent day. No one will die on this day. Surah 50 verse 34. Yawmal khuruj, this will be the day people will come out. Surah 50 verse number 42. Yawmal taghabun, this will be the day when people will look at another and say, how many deeds can I pinch from him? This day is going to be the day of absolute, it's going to be a savage day. Very close, it's coming. It's coming. It's not very far. Because when people will come up on that day, what will they do? When they get together, they will say, how long have we been? We've only stayed on the earth except for 10 days. That's how short it will seem, 10 days. Another person will say, illa yawma. We've only stayed there for just about a day. Another one will say, illa ashiyatan aw duhaha. It only seems like one single evening, one single morning that we've stayed on the earth. That's how short the life of this earth will seem. يَوْمَ الْآزِفَةِ إِذِ الْقُلُوبُ لَدَنْ حَنَاجِرِ كَاظِمِينَ The close day when their hearts will be throbbing where? The hearts will come up to their collarbones. and they will try to move you back down because they're angry with themselves. Kazimeen, they're angry with themselves. Surah 40, verse number 18. يَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ الْأَرْضُ عَنْهُمْ سِرَاعًا. The day when the earth will move very quickly from their heads and they will come up. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. It's a very easy resurrection that I can do. And what is that day when they will come up? Allah said, يَوْمَ يَخْرُجُونَ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ سِرَاعًا كَأَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ نُصُبٍ يُوفِضُونَ. As if they see, they come, when they come up on the Day of Judgment, they will see this pole, this shade on the Day of Judgment, and everyone will run towards it. This is in Surah Al-Ma'ad, it's the 69th verse of the Holy Quran. Allah says, كَأَنَّهُمْ جَرَادٌ مُنْتَشِلٌ. As if they are like locusts that are going crazy. Locusts, have you seen locusts that come back? They're like, there are hundreds of millions of them all over the place. No care for one another. That's how it's going to be. That's in, Allah said that in Surah Al-Qamar, the 54th verse of the 54th Surah of the Quran. And in Surah Qari'ah, Allah said, يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَبْثُوثِ. The day when you'll see people like scattered moths. Moths that are scattered. There is no regard for anyone else. They're just going to be total nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself. What's going to happen to me? What's going to happen to me on this day? Allah has said, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. When your wealth, when your children will not be of any avail to yourself. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except for one that has come with a heart on this day, that is a heart content with myself. This is in Surah 26, verse number 88-89. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِلْغَاوِينَ. Jannah will be made closer to those who have had taqwa, who have had my consciousness. Jahannam will be given a blaze for those who have been sinners. This day, Allah says, إِن تَكُ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ فَتَكُنْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهِ. Any deed you've done, whether it's in the earth, whether it's in space, whether it's in another planet, Allah says, I will bring it about on the Day of Judgment, even if it's an atom's weight. This is in Surah 31, verse 16. يَوْمَئِذٍ, Allah says, يَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ هَذَا يَوْمٌ عَسِرٌ. The one who has denied my message will say, this is a very difficult day for me. Surah 54, verse number 8. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الرُّوحُ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ صَفَّةً. When Jibreel alayhi salam will be there on the Day of Judgment, when all the angels will come together on the Day of Judgment, and all you'll see is what? You'll see hundreds and thousands and millions of angels flying about. They will be descending on that day. Millions and millions of them be doing their duties. What kind of duties? Either giving you a good life on that day or basically punishing you on that day. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ صَفَّى. When all the angels will come and they will stand in one, in many different rows. لَا يَتَكَلَّمُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ وَقَالَ صَوَابًا. No man, no woman will have a single courage to say a single word except whom Allah has given them permission. And they speak the truth. Only those people will be told to speak on that day. In fact, Allah has said, "La tasma'u illa hamsa." In Surah Taha, you will not hear anything except for whispers from people on that day. When people will come on that day, can you imagine what kind of day this is? People will start whispering. What's matter? What's happening? No one will dare look up. Allah said, "Absaruha khasha," looking down on that day. And people have basically come together. And what have they seen when you come up from the Day of Judgment? What kind of things have you seen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger has given us many different situations on that day that people come up. For example, the person who used to beg in this world when he had no reason to beg. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, according to a hadith, which is a hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, this person will come up, he used to beg from people, take money off them when he had no need to beg from people. He will come up on the Day of Judgment and he will not have any flesh or any meat on his bones. He will be a skeleton. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, whoever did not show justice to his wife, that person will come up. He had two wives, but he didn't show justice to one of them. He will come with on the Day of Judgment And he will be split from his head down, right through his nose, right through his body, halfway down, up to his waist. Half of his body will be hanging and half will be straight. And he will walk like that on the Day of Judgment. This is a hadith that is mentioned in Tirmidhi. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person who knew the Quran and who comes up on the Day of Judgment by forgetting the Quran, he'll be a person that will be ajdham. This word ajdham has been used as a riwayah in Abu Dawood, which means that either he will be deformed, his fingers will be lost, parts of his body will be deformed, or he will have no teeth. Some scholars have said he will have no teeth because he was supposed to read the Quran, remember it, but he forgot it. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who doesn't pray salah, as I've said earlier, it's a hadith in Ahmad and Darmi, the one who doesn't pray his salah, he's a believer, he will come up and he will be next to Fir'aun and Qarun and Haman. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who killed somebody else, he killed somebody else, the victim will come, will grab his head, the victim will be able to take his head off, the perpetrator's head, and will show Allah and say, oh Allah, he killed me like this in the world. This is a hadith that has been mentioned in Tirmidhi and Nasa'i. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, any person who helps to kill another person unlawfully on this earth, he will come up on the Day of Judgment, between his eyes there's going to be certain words written here. It's going to be A'isum min rahmatillah. This person is completely hopeless of Allah's mercy on this day. Because he told somebody else, maybe he hired a hitman, she hired a hitman and sent someone to kill someone else. And this is a hadith in Ibn Majah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who makes a promise and he breaks his promise, he will come up on the Day of Judgment and he will have a flag that will be stuck inside his behind, stuck inside the part from where he excretes, right inside his back, in the hole, and it will be high. And he said, the more promises he breaks, the higher the flag will be coming out of his behind. Now, do you see, my brothers, my sisters, what it is to be a Muslim, to keep the promise? And this is a hadith in Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, any person who's a leader or a king, or in any way you're a leader, you will come up on the Day of Judgment with your hands tied to your neck. You will come up like that on the Day of Judgment. And if you have done justice, the justice will come, because justice will be a person on the Day of Judgment. Injustice will be a person on the Day of Judgment. And the justice will come and it will untie your hands. And if it's injustice, then your hands will be tied and you will be punished. These are various ahadith reported from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and one of them is actually mentioned in Darmi. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who doesn't pay his zakat or her zakat will come up on the Day of Judgment, and a great serpent will come, wrap them around from the feet, a dark black serpent, round their shins, round their legs, round their waist, round their body, round their arms, and it will come right in front of their face. And they will be absolutely terrified and say, who are you? What are you? And the snake will say, I am the gold which you never paid zakat on. I am your money which you never paid zakat on. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam read this verse. It is a hadith of Bukhari where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam read the verse where the things they never paid zakat on will be wrapped around their necks on the Day of Judgment. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that the one who is a two-faced in this world, he says one thing to someone, another thing to someone else, and he makes them fight. This is a hadith mentioned in Darmi. That person will come up, wake up with two tongues made of fire. Two tongues made of fire. In fact, in a hadith of Tirmidhi, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, according to hadith of Tirmidhi, the one who's a liar will come up. Imagine you're this on the Day of Judgment. Imagine you're this person. You come up on the Day of Judgment and your tongue, because of the lies that you had said in this world, will be 1 mile long. 1 mile long. Can you imagine millions of people are trying to rush to that pole, try and get under the arsh, and they're basically getting untangled in your tongue, which is 1 mile long. And that's because of the people who lied. in this world. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one who is arrogant, who is the one who is arrogant? The one who is arrogant is the one that puts the truth down and belittles people and feels that they should be the one with the truth when they're one on falsehood. That person who's arrogant, who puts others down, will come upon the day of judgment, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said they will be the size of an ant. You know what the situation of the size of a person of an ant is? Imagine there's an ant here. Who looks at an ant when you are running? Who looks? People will be treading on him, on her, crushing their bones, crushing it, and they will not die. Blood will flow and they will basically, bones will get back to it, and they'll get up and try and run with their little legs towards that center. But they will be crushed again and crushed again and crushed again because they had arrogance in this world. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, the one who listens to information of others which they don't want you to listen to, you eavesdrop and you listen to them when you're not supposed to listen. According to hadith of Bukhari, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, lead will be heated up from Jahannam and put into the ears. Pure lead will be put into the ears. The one who in this world is asked of a knowledge of Islam and he knows the knowledge but he does not give the knowledge. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, according to a hadith of Tirmidhi, they will come up on the day of judgment and there will be a rain around their mouth, just like a horse has a rain, and that whole rain will be made of fire. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said in a sahih hadith, there will be a man who will come up on the day of judgment and he will have two shoes. No one will have shoes, but he's got shoes. He's not a lucky person, he's an unlucky person, because these shoes are made of fire. And they're so hot, his brain starts to melt and bubble. وَإِنَّهُ يَرَى نَفْسَهُ أَنَّهُ أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ عَذَابًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. He thinks that he's got the worst punishment of the day of judgment, while Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said he's got the lightest punishment on the day of judgment. La ilaha illallah. The lightest punishment on the day of judgment. Why? Because he was an arrogant person in this world. Some arrogant people will come up like this on the day of judgment. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, and this is also an ayah in the Holy Quran, some people who deny the message of the Quran will be brought up on the day of judgment on their faces. And they will be made to walk on their faces. You know the way you hop on one foot? They will have to hop on their faces on the day of judgment. Allah has said, نَحْشُرُهُمْ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِهِمْ. I will make them be resurrected on their faces. عُمْيًا بُكْمًا سُمَّ. La ilaha illallah. They will be blind. They will be deaf. They will be dumb. And the Sahaba said, Messenger of Allah, this is in Bukhari, the Sahaba said, Messenger of Allah, how will a person walk on their face on the day of judgment? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do you not see Allah has made people walk on their feet? They said, yes. Likewise, Allah will make some people on the day of judgment walk on their faces. He is the one who is powerful to do that. He will make them walk on their faces. Some of them who denied this message. The one who will come up on the day of judgment, who had anger, and he could have executed his anger. He had the power to take revenge. He was angry. He could have shouted, he could have slapped, he could have done whatever. But he suppressed his anger. You know what Allah will give that person on the day of judgment? Allah will line up every single woman of Jannah. And Allah will say, oh man, choose which woman you want for suppressing your anger. Whichever woman you want of Jannah, that's yours as a wife. There are good things to look forward to on the day of judgment. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who dies in Medina, I will wake up on the day of judgment, I will make shafa'a, I will make intercession for them on the day of judgment. This is in Bayhaqi. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was in Hajj, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Hajj, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is a sahih hadith in Bukhari, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Hajj, and a man fell off his conveyance and he basically fell down and he broke his neck. So he died in Hajj time. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, wash this person, wash him. But he said, don't do what you do with other people and how you bury them and how you basically use his Hajj clothes to wrap him up. and you will basically put him in the grave, just as he is. Why? Because this person will wake up on the day of judgment and he will say, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik Labbaik La Sharika Laka Labbaik. This person will say, oh Allah, I'm present, oh Allah, I'm present. Now how lucky those people are who die in Hajj. You know, if you've lost a family member in Hajj, how lucky these people are. How lucky these people are that they died in Hajj. Why? Because they will wake up on the day of judgment with the ihram and they will be saying, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. The one who's a shaheed in this world, he will wake up, she will wake up on the day of judgment and they will still have blood trickling down their bodies and that blood will smell of musk according to Hadith of Bukhari. And they will say, oh Allah, I did this for you. Oh Allah, this is what I did for you on the earth. Those who gave adhan in this earth, those who gave adhan and used to continuously give adhan, their necks will be much, much higher than other people's necks on the day of judgment. Like the way giraffes have their necks higher than all the other animals in this earth. Because Allah wants to show these people proud on the day of judgment. He wants them to be proud and He wants all people to see that's a mu'adhin and that's a mu'adhin of the day of judgment. Subhanallah. These are things for us to look forward to. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I give good news to those people who will have full faces of nur and light on the day of judgment. Who are these people? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those people who walk to the masjid in the darkness. If your brothers here walk to masjid for Isha and for Fajr, your faces will be bright as the 14th night moon on the day of judgment. Because you walk to Fajr and Isha in this world and that will be your reward on the next world. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will announce, you know, there's some of us, subhanAllah, you know, sometimes you're a believer and you're a good believer and you're honest and you get done in. And people say, gosh, you're so naive, man, you get done in every time. You know, this is a sign of Iman. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, as for the believers, ghirrun kareem, easily deceivable. You can deceive him. And he's a noble person. وَالْمُنَافِقُ خَبٌّ لَئِيمٌ. The munafiq, the hypocrite, the Muslim hypocrite who's got hypocrisy in his actions, he's very clever with his tongue, very deceitful. And those mu'minun, what will be the case of the mu'minun? Because these mu'minun, what do? They love people for the sake of Allah. They love people for the sake of Allah. Allah will announce according to Hadith of Bukhari on the Day of Judgment. أَيْنَ مُتَحَابِي بِجَلَالِي. Where are those people who used to love one another for myself? For my sake they used to love one another. For my sake they used to forgive one another. Where are they on this day of judgment? الْيَوْمَ أُظِلُّهُمْ فِي ظِلِّي يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلِّي. Today I will put you under my throne, under that shade. There is no other shade except for this shade. You will be called specifically on the day of judgment to come under Allah's arsh. And what is under Allah's arsh, my friends? The day when, you know what you will see on the day of judgment? Everyone you will see. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his sahaba, they said, Messenger of Allah, they were really concerned. What were they concerned about? One Bedouin came and he said, Messenger of Allah, this is a hadith in Abu Dawood. He said, Messenger of Allah, when is the last day? When is the last day? And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say when the last day is. He said, ماذا أعددت لها? What have you prepared for the last day? He switched the question. We should be concerned about what? What have you prepared for the last day? He said, Ma a'adattu. He said, Messenger of Allah, I haven't prepared much salah, much fasting, much of these good actions as others have. But I do have two things. And subhanAllah, Allah blessed that sahabi who said that. Because perhaps he's spoken on behalf of many of us sitting here listening to this. He said, I haven't got much actions, but I have two things. He said, what do you have? The Bedouin said, I have the love of Allah and the love of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I have a lot of that. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say anything. He stayed quiet. The Bedouin turned around after a little while thinking he will not get an answer from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he turned around and he started to go outside the masjid. Jibreel alayhi salam came straight to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called that. He said, where's that Bedouin? Call him back here. And he came back. Rasulullah said, and this made the Sahaba more happier than any other day except for the day they embraced Islam. For what came out of the Prophet's mouth. And I want you to listen to this carefully. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Al mar'u man ahabba. On the day of judgment, a man will be with whom he loves. A man whom he loves. If you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than your own father, more than your own children, more than your own friends, then you will be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the day of judgment. You will drink kawthar from his hands. You will meet him on the day of judgment. You will smell his scent from his beloved body on the day of judgment. You will put your neck to his neck on the day of judgment. You will meet Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. You will meet Umar al-Faruq radiyallahu anhu under the arsh, and they will be waiting for you are believers like them. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ. Those who are the first of the first from those who helped, those who migrated with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wal ansar, and those who helped the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in Medina, والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان, and those who followed the Sahaba in a good way and in an excellent manner, رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عن. Allah says, I am pleased with the Muhajireen, I am pleased with the Ansar, and I am pleased with yourselves. I am pleased with you because you followed them. أعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار. I have kept for you gardens on the day of judgment, after which you will get these gardens and you will have the greatest of success on this day. My brothers, look forward to meeting these individuals on the day of judgment. My sisters, look forward to meeting who? Khadija radiallahu anha. Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun, will be there, who said, رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Oh Allah, keep me away from the action of Fir'aun. Oh Allah, give me a house next to you in Jannah. Oh Allah, give me a house next to you in Jannah. This is in Surah Al-Hadid. She said what? رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. My sisters who are in oppression. My sisters who are in oppression, and you've got your husbands not treating you in a nice way. You should look at this ayah in Surah Hadid, where Allah has, in Surah At-Tahrim, the 66th surah of the Holy Quran, near the end. إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ بْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Oh Allah, my husband is not treating me well in this world. I look forward to being close to you in Jannah. Oh Allah, give me a house close to you in Jannah. Oh Allah, keep me close. Meaning what? Jannatul Firdaus, the highest of Jannah. Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun, will be there to meet the sisters on the day of judgment. Khadija radiallahu anha, the most beloved of wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, will be with herself. Cups, these are golden and silver cups, the best of cups you have seen, to take kawthar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was told to say what? He was said what? Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. O Messenger, I have granted for you on the day of judgment the drink of kawthar. Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Continue to pray for me and sacrifice for my sake. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. It will be your enemy that will be left with no sons in this world, but your lineage will carry on in this world. O Prophet, ya ayyuhal muddathir. O one who is wrapped up in my love, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be where on the day of judgment, my brothers? He will be where? He will be under the arsh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the largest fountain on that day of judgment. He will have 120 places for people come to and to drink kawthar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained that kawthar, that drink. Abiyadu min al-laban, whiter than milk. Ahla min al-asal, it will be more sweeter than honey. Man shariba minhu shurbatan lam yadhma ba'dahu abada. Whoever will take one sip of this kawthar on the day of judgment, you can come back out of the arsh, from under the throne. You can come out of that shade on the day of judgment. You can go under that sun on the day of judgment, but you will never be thirsty ever again. Whoever has drunk one single sip on this day from kawthar will never get thirsty ever again. This will be the bounty for whom? For seven categories of people. La ilaha illallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? Imamun adil. This is a hadith in Muslim. One who is a leader, one who is a leader of some people, whether you're a leader of a masjid, you're a leader of a madrasa, you're a leader of a particular group, you're a leader of a whole community of people, you're a leader of a whole country of people, you're a leader of a court in this world. Allah has said, Allah's Messenger has said, Imamun Adil, if you are just, then you will have your place on the Day of Judgment under this arsh. In fact, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, At-tajiruna as-sadiquna ma'al anbiya yawm al-qiyamah. If you are an honest businessman in this world, you will be resurrected with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the Day of Judgment. Allahu Akbar. You're an honest man, you try to have halal. You didn't go down to other people, started to open restaurants and alcohol and businesses that are haram. You kept to what you had to keep to. And you said, Allah has said, no, I'm not going to do it. Allah has said, no, I'm not going to do it. Others were there making haram money. Others were selling drugs. You did not sell drugs. Others were there trying to make money by cheating people in the market. You didn't do that. Others were there trying to rip off people. Allah says, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ. Allah says, woe to those people who, when they take something, they want full in their honor. وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ. And when they give away to people, they want to give less to them. They don't want to give their full share. أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ. Do you not think that you're going to be brought up on the Day of Judgment? أَلَا يَظُنُّ. Do you not have that consideration inside you? مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. A great day. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When people will be standing in front of me on this day, do you have no fear inside you that you cheat people in this world? You go around doing building works for people, and when you do building work, you take money from them and then you don't do their job properly. You sell a car which has faults inside it. If you were to buy a car, you want it to be intact. If you were to buy a house, you want it to be the best house. But when you give your car away, you sell it with dodgy parts. When you sell your house, you sell it with dodgy parts in it. When you sell the milk in a little village somewhere in the world, you put some water in it. When you do this, oh person, do you not think that you will come in front of me on the Day of Judgment? Allahu Akbar. Everyone will be brought on the Day of Judgment with their own deeds. And Allah says, Allah's Messenger says, Imamun Adil, one who has been just in this world, you will have my honor under my arsh. Shabun nasha'a fi ibadatillah. Anyone who's aged between 16 and 25, according to a lot of scholars and according to some scholars, anyone who's aged between 16 and 35, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the young man who starts to become worshipping in Allah, being in his service, being practicing in Allah's way, before you become old. My brothers, my sisters, most of you have got dark hair, most of you, and you've got this chance. A reserved place on the Day of Judgment with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the biggest star. Yes, people will see their favorite football teams on that day. They will see Arsenal, they will see Man United, they will see Milan, they will see all of these. And they will not want to look at them in their face if they have not come with Iman. They will not want to. They had a lot of love for them in this world. They will not want to look at them. They're stars, they're celebrities. They're people that used to walk in this world and they used to look at them and say, I wish I had wealth like them. When the people looked at Qarun, what did they say? Ya layta lana mithla ma utiha Qarun. If only I could have the same money as Qarun. They looked at him and they wanted that. Allah says, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. I swallowed Qarun in the earth. I swallowed his whole treasures in the earth. I swallowed all his trees and all his keys and his treasures in the earth. On the Day of Judgment, Qarun will come up with his treasures that gave him no benefit. تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ. Abu Lahab saw the messenger, he didn't get Iman. Allah says, he is perished, his hands are perished. مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبْ. Neither his wealth gave him benefit, nor did any of his earnings give benefit on the Day of Judgment. سَيَصْلَى نَارًا ذَاتَ لَهَبْ. On that day he will be cast in a fire that will be blazing. وَمْرَأَتُهُ حَمَّالَةَ الْحَطَبْ. They used to put thorns in the way of my Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to get pricked by these people with thorns. The thorns in his feet. And this woman used to do this. And Allah says, وَمْرَأَتُهُ حَمَّالَةَ الْحَطَبِ. This woman will be made to have come up on the Day of Judgment with a whole wood piece of fire that will hold her arms, hold her wrists and her neck in this fire. فِي جِيدِهَا حَبْلٌ مِّن مَّسَدٍ. She will have a rope of fire around her neck. She'll be screaming on that day. My brothers, my sisters, you've done zulum, you've done oppression on this earth. Get it sorted out. Get it sorted out before that day comes. Because forget getting the time when you're going to sort it out with somebody else. You don't know, and I don't know how we're going to come up on that day of judgment. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Shabun nasha'a fi ibadatillah." A young person who becomes practicing in his young life. You saw your friends, they were going down the wrong path, you went down the right path. You saw your friends going down the pathway of gangs and gangsters, you came to the masjid. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَضْحَكُونَ. Those who are sinners in this earth, they used to laugh at the believers when the believers used to practice. Your friends are laughing at you because you have a bit of a beard. Your friends are laughing at you because you're trying to become practicing. Your friends are saying, I've got girls, I've got all of this pleasure, you've got nothing for yourself. Allah says, on the فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ. You, O believer, will be there on the Day of Judgment. I will give you cushions to recline on. You'll be reclining on these cushions and you'll be laughing at the ones who laughed at you in this world. You'll be laughing at them, or those who are ungrateful to me in this world. Young person, my friend, book your place in the Day of Judgment. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Rajulun qalbuhu mu'allakum bil masajid." A man whose heart is not attached to what? It's not attached to games. It's not attached to some home. It's not attached to his family and friends. It is more attached to the house of whom? To the house of Allah. Every time he leaves the masjid, he wants to come back to the masjid for the next prayer. If your heart is like this and if your action is like this, you have guaranteed yourself on the Day of Judgment a place under Allah's arsh. Subhanallah. Rajulani mutahabban. Two men that love one another for Allah's sake. Allah will put them on the Day of Judgment. Rajulun da'athu imra'atun dhatu mansabin wa jamal. A person who has been called. I'm just going to ask, please, the committee members, give 5 minutes, inshallah. A person who has been called in this world by a woman to come and to complete his shahwa, complete his desires. She says, come to me. She has wealth. She has beauty. She says, come to me. Let us sleep together. He says, inni akhafullah. I fear Allah. That man, Allah will bring him on the Day of Judgment, and you will be next to the prophets on the Day of Judgment. Allahu Akbar. Or a woman who says that to the man, the same thing applies. Inni akhafullah. I fear Allah. My brothers, just once you can say that. Once with your courage and with your taqwa and iman, you say that and you pull yourself away from that. If you've got a girlfriend and sisters, you've got a boyfriend, you pull away from that evil desire in this earth. Right now you do that, Allah will book you that place on the Day of Judgment. Rajulun, there's a man, tasaddaqa biyaminihi la ta'lamu shimalu. He gives something with his right hand in charity, not his left hand knows. That man, Allah will put him on the Day of Judgment with the messengers, with the greatest celebrities on that day, on the Day of Judgment next to them. And if you can't make it from any of these brothers, then there's a very simple one Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said. رَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ. A man or a woman who starts to remember Allah in secrecy and their eyes shed tears. They say, Allah, 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 and their eyes shed tears. This is a person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put under his arsh on the Day of Judgment. Now tell me, my brothers, if you know of at least one of these ways that you can make it under Allah's arsh. One of these ways you can do while you're still alive. Put your hands up. If you know at least one way, everybody knows a way, and you will have to get one of these ways before we actually end up on the Day of Judgment, and this will be our fate. Inshallah, what we will do is we will carry on next month with this program, and it will be about standing in front of Allah on the Day of Judgment. We're going to make a short dua before the adhan is given, inshallah. Please join together. Let's make a dua. Sallallahu ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad salatan tunajjina biha min jami'il ahwali wal afat wa taqdi lana biha jami'al hajat wa tudahhiruna biha min jami'is sayyiat wa tarfa'una biha a'la ad-darajat وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Oh Allah, we have wronged ourselves, and if you don't have mercy on us, if you don't have pity on us, then we will be of the losers. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة. Oh our Lord, give us the best in this world. وفي الآخرة حسنة, give us the best in the next world. وقنا عذاب النار, and save us from the punishment of the fire. وقنا عذاب القبر, save us from the punishment of the grave. وقنا عذاب القبر, وقنا عذاب الحشر, save us from the punishment of the day of judgment when everyone will be resurrected. Oh Allah, we ask you, Mawla, to give us a place on the day of judgment straight away under your arsh. Oh Allah, let us meet the messengers. Let us be with Musa alayhi salam, with Nuh alayhi salam, with Ibrahim Khalil alayhi salam. Oh Allah, let us be in their presence with the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. Oh Allah, we do tawbah to you, Mawla. Oh Allah, we seek your pardon, Mawla. Oh Allah, this is a clear tawbah to you. Oh Allah, you forgive all our sins, Mawla. Oh Allah, forgive our major sins. Forgive our minor sins. Oh Allah, we will not sin again, Mawla. Oh Allah, we will not sin again, Mawla. Oh Allah, we will not oppress one another, Mawla. Oh Allah, we will not cheat, oh Allah. Oh Allah, we will not lie, Mawla. Oh Allah, Mawla, these eyes that have sinned, Mawla, wipe the sins from them before a day comes when you know the secrets of the eyes. Oh Allah, these hands that have sinned, Mawla, we are shameful to raise these hands in front of you, Mawla. Oh Allah, wipe the sin from my hands before a day comes when our hands come up on the day of judgment. Oh Allah, oh Mawla, these feet that have walked towards sin. Oh Allah, oh Mawla, forgive us. Oh Allah, these mouths and these tongues that have talked a lot of sin. Oh Allah, forgive us. Mawla, let us meet you in a state that our bodies have not a single sin upon it. Oh Allah, let us meet you in a state that you are pleased with us, let us be pleased with you. Let us meet you on the day of judgment when you will say, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutma'inna, O content soul, irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyya. Return to your Lord, you being pleased with your Lord and your Lord being pleased with you. Fadkhuli fi ibadi, come amongst my righteous servants. وَدْخُلِي جَنَّتِي, and come into my garden. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَى خَيْرِ خَلْقِهِ مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ بِرَحْمَتِكَ يَا أَرْحَمَ الرَّاحِمِينَ.